Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our online streaming. I'm Reverend Yvonne Pettifer. This is Hope in the Word of Ministries. Welcome and God bless you, everybody who's tuning in, whether it's live or whether it's later. We're just thankful that you're with us and that we're praying that you receive a blessing through this ministry. And so on behalf of my husband, Reverend Larry Pettifer, and myself, again, welcome. Welcome to Hope in the Word Ministries. And just before we get into our word this morning, just if you might be joining us on Facebook, you might be joining us on, you know, our website or later on our YouTube channel, but we're just encouraging you to check out our website, www.hopeintheWordMinistries.com. You can read more about us and our ministry and about my husband and myself and learn a little bit more about our backgrounds and more about this ministry, where our hope lies, and Hope in the Word Ministries. Also, we have a contact page where if you want to invite us to speak at one of your engagements, you can contact us through there. Also, we're encouraging you to send us your prayer requests through our contact. Our email is there. Our email address is there online. And also donations. We're always, welcome for donations. And we appreciate each and every one of them as we continue to bless other ministries as we go on throughout the rest of this year ending and to the next year. Continue to bless those and try to bring hope through God's word to other ministries. So welcome. And also, we have our wall of preachers that we have up that we pray for. And so we put down ministers that God has put on our hearts, Bishop Sylvester Robinson, Elder Tommy Nukes, and Bishop William Burden, who are out there on the front lines, the battle lines, and proclaiming the good news of Jesus Christ. And so we lift those men of God up, and I will do that in my prayer and their churches. So welcome again, everyone, and I'm just going to go ahead and get started into our word for today and coming off that Christmas season, still in the Christmas season, and praying that it's always in your heart. So I'm going to give you a moment to find, it's just a short scripture this morning, Matthew chapter 2, verse 11. So I'll give you a moment to find it in your Bible, on your phone, on your computer, whatever you have. And if you don't have any of those things, as I always say, just open up your heart. You can always go back and read it later. Open up your heart to what God would have you to receive. So Matthew chapter 2, verse 11. And it says, "And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh." May the Lord add the blessing to the reading of his holy word. Hallelujah. Let's just bow our heads and our hearts in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you with thanksgiving in our hearts, giving you all the praise and all the glory. And we thank you for Jesus Christ who died on that cross to save our sinful souls. We lift up this service to you, and let me decrease that you would increase. It's not about us. It's not about this ministry, but it's about Jesus Christ, and it's about winning lost souls for the kingdom of heaven. And we're praying that those that watch, those that hear, someone's life would be saved, someone's heart changed, lives changed, someone encouraged, someone lifted up out of whatever that they're going through, that Satan has them bound in, and that the chains are broken, and that the angels in heaven are rejoicing over the lost souls that are won. And we just thank you so much for your gift of Jesus Christ. We thank you for your word, and for planting it in our hearts. We just give you all the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Praise God, everybody. My title this morning is The Gifts of Christmas. The Gifts of Christmas. And I wanted to take a look, a little bit of a look at what the wise men gave to Jesus Christ. You know, coming off of Christmas this week. But Christmas isn't over. It should be in our hearts each and every single day. Just think, reflecting on, did you get any gifts? Maybe you did, maybe you didn't. Maybe you gave gifts. I don't know what your situation is, but I want to take a look at the wise men for just a moment, and then going into gifts that we hopefully received this Christmas season. So we know the story of the wise men in Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 2. "Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born King of Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him." They were on a mission to worship Jesus Christ. And getting back to our text for today, Matthew 2:11, "And when they were coming to the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh." The wise men gave gifts to Jesus when they saw him. They gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And if you're studying those three gifts, it is believed that those gifts had symbolic meaning to them for Jesus Christ. That gold, they gave him gold, which represents wealth. It's a gift fit for a king. Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of your lords. Yes, he is. They gave him frankincense. It's an incense that is used to worship God that showed a gift for his deity. Jesus is the Son of God. And myrrh, a fragrant perfume used to anoint the dead, to embalm and preserve them. Jesus is the sacrificial lamb. He died on that cross to save your sinful soul. So that gold showed that he was the King of Kings. The wise men knew who he was. He was the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. That frankincense, he showed that he is the Son of God. Jesus is the Son of God, showed his deity. And that myrrh showed that he was the sacrificial lamb, that he would go to the cross and die for our sins. Those gifts were given to Jesus by the wise men. But there's some other gifts that I want to look at this morning. The gifts of Christmas. Hope, peace, love, and salvation. And I'm praying that you receive those gifts. Let's look at that first gift, the gift of hope. What does hope mean? Hope means to expect with confidence. Hope is not an I don't know if it's going to happen, or I'm just wonder if it's going to happen. No, hope, when we hope in God, when hope is when God has promised that something is going to happen and you put your trust in that promise. That Christian hope is a confidence that something will come to pass because God has promised it will come to pass. Hope. Jeremiah 17:7 says, "Blessed is the man whose hope is in the Lord." What does our hope lie in? Christ Jesus. Jesus Christ is our hope. I believe that God gave our ministry that name, Hope in the Word Ministries, because I believe that our hope lies in God's Word. Jesus Christ is the Word. Jesus Christ is our hope. Get into God's Word. There's your hope right there. And I love giving scriptures because I believe that everything in life, everything in our lives, everything that we're going through lies right here in the Word of God. Romans 15:4 says, "For whatsoever things were written before were written for our learning, that we through the patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope." Comfort of the scriptures. You have to be in God's word. "By the patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope." Get into God's word. Hope in the word. 1 Timothy 1:1 says, "Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the commandment of God our Savior and the Lord Jesus Christ, our hope." Our hope lies in Jesus Christ. You got to know him. You got to know him. God gave us some wonderful gifts at Christmas. Let them be in your heart each and every day. Not just this Christmas time. Don't just say Christmas is over, it's come and gone for another year. No, it should lie in your heart each and every single day. Don't have the after Christmas blues where it's all over just because the music might be gone, the lights of Christmas tree turned off. No, Christmas should be alive and well in your heart. Your hope lies in Jesus Christ. Titus 2:1-2 says, "In hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie promised before the world began. God is truthful. He is free from all deceit. The salvation that God has promised to each of us who believes in Jesus Christ will be fulfilled. You can trust in that. You can trust in God. You can trust in his word. Our hope lies in Jesus Christ. He gave us a gift when he sent Jesus Christ to this world. He wrapped it up in swaddling clothes and put it in a manger. For us, for each and every one of us. That hope, our hope for eternal life is in Jesus Christ. Get into God's word. Satan wants to keep you from his word because he knows once you get into it, you will have hope. You will have peace. You will have love. You will have that salvation when you're in God's word. Trust in God. Accept Jesus Christ into your life. That is your hope. Titus 2:13 says, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Oh yeah, he's coming back. He's coming back for each and every one of us that believe in his name. Don't go through this life hopeless. Titus 3:7, that being justified by his grace, we should be made heirs according to the hope of eternal life. Our hope lies in Jesus Christ. I can't say it enough because I know somebody sitting there that has no hope. If our future is not secured and satisfied by God, when we are going to be excessively anxious, then we're going to be excessively anxious. But our scripture tells us to be anxious for nothing. When we do not have hope in the Lord, we are paralyzed by fear. This world will paralyze you. There's no hope in this world. Your hope lies in Jesus Christ. I'm going to say it over and over and over again. Your hope lies in Jesus Christ. When you don't have hope in Jesus, you're paralyzed by fear of what the future brings. But when we have faith in Christ, we have hope for things eternal. Hallelujah. Things that will never decay or waste away. Praise God. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Grab a hold of him. God gave us a gift in Jesus Christ. He gave us a gift of hope. Romans 15:13 says, now the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you may abound in hope. It's right here. Get into God's word. Go back and read this message, so that look at this message and write the scriptures down if you have to. Pick out one. My hope, say it every day. My hope lies in Jesus Christ. There are so many people in this world that are hopeless. So many people, and I wrote a few things down as I was doing my research, that so many people around, you know, my husband was talking to somebody and telling him Merry Christmas. He says, I'm not going to have a Christmas. He's lonely. He's without hope. Nobody around him. But Jesus Christ is his hope. I'm going to read a few things that I had found that people are saying. One says, I'm so tired of my life. Everyone hates me. I feel worthless, suicidal, and depressed. People wanted to commit suicide, wanted to take their life. Why? Because they have no hope, because they don't know Jesus Christ. That's why they don't have any hope. Your hope lies in Jesus Christ. If you feel hopeless this morning, grab onto him. Unwrap that gift that God gave to you, that he put in a manger in swaddling clothes. He wrapped it up in swaddling clothes, laid it in a manger so that you would have hope. Hope in this world. Hope for eternal life. Somebody else said, no one cares about me and I hate everything about myself and I want to die because I'm so unlovable and I have no purpose. I can't see a reason why I should stay alive and I've lost hope. A third, when I feel angry, lonely, irritable, suicidal, worthless, and hopeless. I hate my job and everything about my life. I just want to feel happy. See, things in this world are not going to make you happy. Your hope, your happiness is in Jesus Christ alone. If you're feeling hopeless this morning, Jesus Christ is the hope for the hopeless. Jesus Christ offers real hope. Hallelujah. He offers a full life to those who accept Jesus into their hearts. John 10:10 says, I have come that they may have life and that they might have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. This abundant life never ends. There is a hope of life everlasting based upon the promises of God in who? Jesus Christ. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. John 11:25-26. Praise God. Your hope is in Jesus Christ. He is hope for the hopeless. If you feel like there is no hope for your future, he has a future and a hope for you. A future and a hope, a plan for your life, abundant life, a plan for eternal life. Grab a hold of him. That gift of Christmas, the gift of hope through Jesus Christ. God gave it to you. Grab a hold of it. Unwrap it. It's free. Everlasting life is free. Hope is free. Just believe in Jesus Christ. Let him come into your heart. Say it every day. I have hope. I have hope in Jesus. I have hope in Jesus. Praise God. The gifts of Christmas. That number one gift, hope. The second one I want to talk about is the gift of peace. Praise God. What is peace but freedom from anxiety? Freedom from annoyance or other mental disturbance. Oh yes, in our minds. See, Satan tries to grab a hold of your mind. Yes, he will. He'll cloud your mind with all kinds of things, that there is no peace. You have no mental peace. Your mind is disturbed each and every single day because there's no peace. No peace. Where does that peace come from? But through Jesus Christ. That's another gift of Christmas. Hallelujah. The gift of peace. That first gift, that gift of hope. And we went back and said what hope is. To expect with confidence. To expect with confidence. We have hope in Jesus Christ, and we have peace. The peace of God through Jesus Christ. Oh, he wrapped it up in swaddling clothes and laid it in a manger for you. Unwrap that peace in your life. And as I was looking, oh my goodness, that peace of God. Freedom from anxiety. Freedom from mental disturbance. In Isaiah 26:3-4, it says, thou wilt keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee because he trusteth in thee. Praise God. Trust ye in the Lord forever, for in the Lord Jehovah is everlasting strength. If you trust in God, he'll give you peace. Not peace in this world, because there is no peace in this world. What keeps us from having peace in our minds? You might have worry this morning. But Psalm 34:4 says, I sought the Lord and he answered me. He delivered me from all my fears. You might have doubt. You might have fear. Fear is not of the Lord. Confusion is not of the Lord. Confused about which way to heaven. There's only one way to heaven, and that's through Jesus Christ. It's believing in Jesus Christ. Confusion, worry, doubt, fear, sickness might be causing you to have an unrestful mind. No peace of mind because you're worried about what your future holds. Trust in the Lord. Whether you're sick, yeah, my husband has some health issues, as we've said, but we trust in God. We can have peace in the midst of our storms because we trust in our Heavenly Father. We have to keep our minds stayed on him to get us through each and every single day, through the battles, through the medication, through the doctors, through the hospital visits. Yeah, we go through it. We're Christians, but sometimes we still walk through that valley of the shadow of death. But we know that God watches over us. God walks through us each and every day. He walks with us by his rod and his staff. He comforts us. He gives us peace. He leads us and guides us through the storms that we face. We can have happiness and joy in our hearts because of that peace, because we trust in God. Oh yeah, we're not just up here talking things that we don't know about. I can testify because God has brought us through many of things. Yeah, we can have peace in the midst of storm because we trust in our Heavenly Father. Because we have Jesus Christ in our hearts. That gift of peace. Maybe you're lonely. Many people are lonely. Many people may have spent Christmas Day without anybody to love them. Without anybody to say Merry Christmas to them. Without anybody to wake up with in their house full of joy. But I'm telling you, if you hang on to Jesus Christ, he'll be your friend. He's a friend to the lonely. He'll mend your broken heart. He'll give you peace in your mind. There's peace through Jesus Christ. Anxiousness, don't be anxious. Hatred, maybe there's no room for peace in your heart because you have too much hate in your heart. I spoke last week about You know, are you ready for Christmas? You got to get rid of those things in your heart so that you can have peace in your mind, have peace in your heart. Got to give you a clean heart so that you can serve Him. Got to give you a clean heart that you can get rid of that hatred. Got to give you a clean heart. Accept Jesus Christ into your life. You might have anger and bitterness, as I read in some of those letters that people are saying. They're posting things because they have nobody. They're calling people, maybe suicidal hotlines, or just reaching out because there's no hope. They have no peace in their hearts. Maybe you're pursuing the material things in their life. Nothing wrong with having a nice home. We need shelter. We need a car to get us back and forth. Transportation. We want a nice home. Yes, of course, we want those things in the comfort of when it rains or when it snows or wherever you are, to have that shelter. But if that's what you're looking for to give you peace and happiness, you're going down the wrong road. You need to go down that road of peace. You need to unwrap that gift of peace that God has given to you. Those material things mean nothing. We are trying to quest for a bigger house or a nicer car, more expensive clothing. There is no peace in that, I'm telling you. That sinful life. Maybe there's no peace in your life because you're full of sin and you're doing things that you shouldn't be doing. But how can you have peace this morning? Through Jesus Christ. Romans 5:1 says, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through who? Our Lord Jesus Christ. You got to have Him. You got to have Him to have that hope. You need Jesus Christ to have that peace. Philippians 4:8 says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. Praise God. Because when we think on the things of this world, when we think on how somebody did us wrong, or when we think about something that happened 25 years ago and we can't let go of, or we think on that person that walked out on us and we let it fester in our minds, and we think on how we want to get revenge on somebody, or we think on that unforgiveness, or we think about our bodies, how we don't feel good, you know, we go through things, and we're worried about how food is going to be put on our tables. He said, don't worry about how you're going to be fed, how you're going to be clothed. He takes care of the birds of the air. He'll take care of you too. So when we have those fears, Satan tries to put those fears in our mind so that we don't have any peace in God. But when you have Jesus Christ, you can have that everlasting peace. The gifts of Christmas. Oh, I like what I read when it says, Psalm 34:14 says, depart from evil and do good. This next part, hallelujah. Seek peace and pursue it. Those words just jumped out at me. Seek peace and pursue it. What does to seek mean? Seek means to search for something, to try to obtain something. The scripture says to seek peace. So you have to search for it. That's why that scripture I just read in Philippians 4, it says you got to think on those things. That's why I said you got to be in God's word. See, when those thoughts come into our minds that you're unlovable, or nobody cares, or should I take my life, or I'm lonely. When you're in God's word, see, He can give you a scripture to take that away from you. A scripture, the joy of the Lord is my strength. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. There is something in here for everything that you're going through. Let Him put joy in your heart. Let Him give you peace of mind. Think on the good things of the Lord. Praise God. I'm going back to that scripture where it says, seek peace and pursue it. Maybe you want to hang on to that one this week. Psalm 34:14. Depart from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. Maybe you're doing evil things in your life. He wants you to turn around and do good. Seek peace. I'm going to keep going with that. Seek again means to search, to try to obtain something. Then it says, and pursue it. Pursue means to follow in order to overtake something. Praise God. And I'm telling you, we read scriptures, but sometimes we can read it for the 1,000th time and something new will jump out at us. Praise God, that just leapt in my spirit when I read this week, seek peace and pursue it. We've got to go after it. Go after it. Satan is coming after you. He came to steal, kill, and destroy. And he will do it if you let him. Seek that peace and pursue it. Again, pursue means to follow and overtake it. Overtake that peace. Trust in God. Think on the goodness of the Lord. The abundant life that he wants you to have. That can never be destroyed. That Satan can't take away from you. That will not decay. That gift of eternal life. That gift of hope for the hopeless. That gift of peace of mind through Jesus Christ. And what does it say? Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Yes, he is. John 14:27 says, peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Pursue peace. Oh, I'm praying that somebody will have peace in their mind. Because when your mind is tormented, all the things that we hear on TV or people might whisper to you or Satan is whispering to you can just mess you up. You might lose sleep over it because you have no peace. Praise God. He wants to give you that peace. This world can't offer you anything. There's no peace in pursuing the worldly things. Pursue Jesus Christ. Pursue the peace of God in your heart. The gifts of Christmas. Oh, he wrapped it up for you. And he gave it to you freely. The gifts of Christmas. Hope. Peace. Pursue it. Pursue peace. The gift of love. Strong feelings of affection. Everybody wants to be loved. Come on. Everybody wants to be loved. Sometimes you hear stories of young girls, they want to have a baby, and you hear them say, because I want somebody to love. They don't have any love in their lives, and that baby will bring them that love. So they have somebody to hold, somebody that they can shower upon. And somebody to, in return, to love them. People walking through this life not feeling loved. But God sent his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. He wrapped him up in swaddling clothes, laid him in a manger. Yes, he did. Praise God. The gift of love. The gifts of Christmas. And I'll go back to these in just a moment. Kind of reiterate that hope. That peace. But that love. God is love. I can't say it enough. 1 John 4:7-9. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God. And everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. In this, the love of God was manifested toward us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him. God has given us the greatest gift of all. As I said, in my other sermon, you know, you can't, the gift of Jesus Christ is free. The gift that God has given to us is free. So you don't have to check your credit cards, as I said before. This is a gift you don't have to return. Praise God. And then once you get a hold of Jesus Christ, once you unwrap the gift that God has given to you, that eternal life, the gift of Jesus Christ, oh no, you don't want to give it back. That is a forever gift. You don't have to stand in the line at Walmart or package it up and take it back to the post office and send it back where it came from or put it on the shelf because it's an unwanted gift. We may have given gifts that people didn't want or received gifts that that you didn't want, that you can't use it. People say, oh, I'm going to re-gift that. I don't know. But I'm telling you one thing. The gift of Jesus Christ is free. Everlasting life is free. You won't want to return this gift, but you want to share it. Yes, you do. Hallelujah. When you receive this gift of Jesus Christ, open it up. That gift of hope, that gift of peace, that gift of love. God is love. He loves you. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning that you're sitting there crying because you're lonely. You have nobody that picks up the phone to call you. You have nobody to go to sit down and have a meal with. You have nobody that you feel like cares about you. But Jesus Christ does. God loves you so much. I'm talking about just you. He loved you so much that he sent Jesus Christ, his only begotten son, to die on that cross just for you. That is love. So when Satan says nobody loves you, Satan is a liar. There is no truth in him. He is the father of lies. Lying is an abomination to the Lord. Satan is the father of lies. When he starts lying to you and said there's no hope, that nobody loves you, nobody cares, that is a lie from the pit of hell. Jesus Christ does. God loves you so much that he sent his son to die on that cross for you. Just you. I'm talking about, make it personal. Just say it. Jesus died for me. Say it over and over and over. Hallelujah. Your spirits will start to be lifted. Praise God. Jesus died for me. Yes, he did. Say it again. Jesus died for me. Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the Prince of peace, the bright and morning star, came down to this earth wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger, and died on that cross, and rose again so that you would have eternal life, so that you would have hope for a future. Jeremiah 29, 11, 13 says, "For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace." There's that peace again. He wants you to have peace. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you what? A future and a hope. It is in Jesus Christ that you have that future. It is in Jesus Christ that you have that hope. Praise God. But it goes on to say something more. Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you. Oh yeah, that's the Heavenly Father talking to you. Get on your knees and pray to him. Call on him. You got to seek him with your whole heart. And it goes on and says, "And you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all your heart." Hallelujah. You got to search for it. Do something. Get up off of your seat. Get up on your feet or get on your knees. Whatever it takes. Or if you can't, maybe you said, "I can't get up." Raise your hand or raise your heart. He died for you. He loves you. He gave you a gift this Christmas. Christmas isn't over. Let it be alive and well in your heart each and every single day. Let it manifest. Let that hope manifest. Let that peace manifest. Let that love manifest in your heart. Unwrap the gift of Jesus Christ. There's no reason to go through this life hopeless. No matter what you're going through, he is there for you. He loves you. Seek him. Seek him with your whole heart. Seek that peace. Oh yeah, I know our hearts get broken sometimes. But he will mend the brokenhearted. He will help you in this life. Until that great and wonderful day when we see him face to face. Every knee shall bow. Oh, yeah. You can rest assured, every knee shall bow. Every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You may not know him right now, but I guarantee you, every knee shall bow. Every knee and every tongue will confess Jesus Christ is Lord. Don't leave this earth and die and go to hell. You don't have to. He gave you a gift this Christmas. Don't let Satan snatch it from you. Don't sit there and say, "I didn't receive anything." Oh, yes, you did. Yes, you did. You just have to grab hold of it. You've got to seek it. You've got to open it up. You've got to let it manifest in your heart. You've got to trust in God. You've got to accept Jesus Christ into your heart. And I'm going to go back and say, God has given us the greatest gift of all, His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. He wrapped Him in swaddling clothes, laid Him in a manger for each and every one of us. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. This ministry is Hope in the Word Ministries. We are here to win souls for Christ. That is the first and foremost thing that this ministry is about, to win souls for the kingdom of God, to preach the good news of Jesus Christ. The gifts of Christmas, salvation, everlasting life is free. Oh, one of my favorite songs growing up, I grew up in Indiana. It was a song that the church would sing. It's called Everlasting Life. I loved it with everything in me. Everlasting life is free. I'm so glad Jesus gave it to me. Everlasting life is free. Oh, praise God. Don't you just shout that right there, just enough to just thank God. Thank the Lord for His gift of Jesus Christ. Oh, just raise your hands this morning. Praise Him with me. Just thank God for that gift that He didn't have to, He gave it freely. You don't have to do anything for it, but accept Jesus Christ into your heart. There's no gift receipt on it. There's no payment on it. He paid the price for you. He paid the price for you, for me, for each and every one of us. So that we would not have eternal damnation, but that we would have eternal life through Jesus Christ. Excuse me. Salvation, the gifts of Christmas. It's not something bought at Walmart. It's not something bought at Kohl's. It's not a gift card. It's everlasting life. It's Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the Prince of Peace, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Great I Am. Salvation, the gifts of Christmas. Ephesians 2:8-9 says, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. Hallelujah, here it is. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. There's nothing that you can do. There's nothing that you can do to earn the gift of God. It's freely given. The gifts of Christmas, that hope for the hopeless, that peace from the Prince of Peace, the love. God is love. And that's salvation only through Jesus Christ. Only through Jesus Christ. Everlasting life. Everlasting life is free. Praise God. Hallelujah, everybody. Oh, I just feel that anointing in my spirit. I feel that Holy Spirit in this place that I'm praying. It comes from here to you. It's nothing about me. Let me decrease that He increases. It is not about us at all, but it is about what Jesus Christ did on that cross. It is about, I'm just praying that somebody gives their life to Christ this morning. The gift of Jesus Christ. And I'm going to say it again. No gift receipt needed. No need to stand in line to return it. Once you receive the gift of Jesus Christ, you can have the hope of salvation, the peace of God, the love of God, and everlasting life through Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, the Prince of Peace. 2 Corinthians 9:15 says, thanks be unto God for His unspeakable gift, the gifts of Christmas. Oh, don't you want it? Don't you want Jesus Christ to live in your heart? Don't you want eternal life? Don't you want to go through this life knowing that there's hope for eternity? There is hope, there is love, there is peace, there is salvation only through Jesus Christ. Get into your word. Satan wants to keep you from it. Why? Because he knows that there is freedom in here. There is freedom in Christ. There is freedom from that worry. There is freedom from that doubt. There is freedom from fear. What's in here? This is about Jesus. There is hope, peace, love, and salvation, praise God. But if you don't know him this morning, wherever, whenever you watch it, maybe you're watching it live, maybe you're going to watch it later, I don't know. We're just praying that that same anointing will go forth whenever it is. Whoever watches it, if it's one person, praise God, that one person has hope, that one person has peace, that one person feels that love, that one person has salvation and gives their life to Jesus Christ. That's what it's all about. But if you don't know him and you want to give your life to him this morning, if you want to give your life to Jesus, just say this prayer with me, and I'm going to turn this back on. Say this prayer with me. Hallelujah. Dear Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I am a sinner and need your forgiveness. I believe that your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, shed his blood on the cross and died for my sins. And now I want to turn from my sins. I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in my heart that you raised him from the dead. I invite Jesus Christ to come into my life as my personal Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for my sins and giving me the gift of eternal life. Amen. Praise God. Romans 10:9 says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. And I'm praying that somebody's life was saved this morning. Or whenever, like I said, you might watch it on YouTube later. It might be the midnight hour. You might be ready to take your life and you see this message and you know that there is hope through Jesus Christ. The angels in heaven are rejoicing with you. Praise God, everybody. Praise God. I'm praying that the gifts of Christmas are in your heart each and every single day. God bless you. God bless you, everyone. And I'm going to try to turn this back on. And just listen to the music as we close out. Praise the Lord. Give love on Christmas Day. Jesus Christ is that love. Praise God, everybody. God bless you. This is Hope in the Word Ministries. Hope to see you Thursday for our Hope in the Word Thursdays at 5 p.m. God bless you. Send us those prayer requests. We're praying with you. We're praying for you. We're praying that you have that hope, that peace, that love in your hearts, that you receive the gift of salvation. That gift of salvation through Jesus Christ, God's only begotten Son, that he died on that cross to save your sinful souls. Have a blessed day. Remember, this is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. God bless you, everybody. And I'm gonna come back for just a moment. I was just listening to that Give Love on Christmas Day. When you receive that gift of love, maybe you already have it, but share it with somebody. And that was just on my heart as I was standing back there. Share it with somebody. Share that gift of Jesus Christ with those that you see. It might be one person. You don't need a big platform, but share the love of Christ. Oh, hallelujah. I could just feel that Holy Spirit. Share the love of Christ. Praise God. Just worship Him. Just worship from where you are. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Just worship Him. Praise God. Share the gift of Jesus Christ. God bless you, everybody.